It's not this hot light on my face. It's a workshop, so people.
Everybody, on behalf of the real deal, we have arrived at a point. Our next speakers, who are from the Southern California Society for Paranormal Research, and they are going to talk about some areas that are close to here, the old Camarillo State Hospital, which is about that way from here. And then the Mission La Purisima, which is up by Yulton and the Danish town of Lombok. Oh, is that one? Oh, I have one, but San Ynez is by. Yeah. Okay, up by Lombok. But anyway, they know it better than I do. What we have here, after that stellar job of introduction, we have Frank and Lewis, and they're going to tell us all about it. So let's thank them for coming. Yeah.
We're going to let him ready to call. He's on his way. Should be here.
We'll just go start with off call. During the course of the presentation, feel free to ask. This presentation was put together mainly by Frank Reckless. I want to thank him for taking the time for that together. Just thought that people like to see pictures with the story, so hopefully we're going to accomplish that tonight. So, without further ado, we're missing one of our members, like I said, Paul Major. He's en route here from Los Angeles, where he's on location filming a movie. Just a little bit about our group. We were formed in 2001, and the time has flown really pretty quick. You know, it's just time flies. But our group was born out of a situation that arose for me. I mean, I don't know how many of you are familiar with the rivalries that exist in paranormal circles. For whatever reason, there exists in this small subculture an environment of rivalry that to this day I can't explain. My forming this group was kind of out of result of a bad experience that I had in trying to get together just to investigate and to.
Okay, where have we investigated? We're just going to go through and just kind of show you some pictures and places that we've been to and investigated many times. Obviously, Queen Mary, a stranger to anybody, I'm sure, of being an active place. CSUCI, formerly Camarillo State Hospital, which we'll be talking about tonight. Michelle Maparizima, Lompoc, California. We've been to the Linda Vista Hospital, which has been abandoned now for about 10 years, and actually in East Los Angeles.
They made them into Lofts, Kendall. You can't investigate there any longer, sadly.
The Cravens Estate in Pasadena with Peter James. Shadow Ranch House in Canoga Park. Andres Pico Adobe in San Fernando. Mission San Fernando. Old place in East LA called Casa de Mexicana, which is over 100 years old. We were fortunate enough to take Peter James there, who was able to identify several spirits there.
It used to be an old Jewish synagogue. It was really prevalent at the time in the Boyle Heights area. There was a lot of Jewish synagogues in the area, and it used to be, it used to house, this building in particular used to house a Jewish synagogue. And they, it turned into kind of a makeshift community center for the people in the barrio of Los Angeles. And we'll talk a little bit more about this picture. You're probably kind of wondering what that is.
Can you guys see that?
Can you guys see this photo?
Yes.
I actually caught that. That's the way it came out. I actually caught that on our first time there. I was taking my fifth picture, and I caught that. This was at night. It was taken at night, so there's no daylight at all. See the window there in the background. So.
By the way, this was a series of photos. This is not just the only photo that we caught that evening that had that. I think you took about four or five shots in succession, and all of them had this weird thing on it. I asked Peter James later on if he had any impressions of there being a fire there at any point, because that's what it kind of reminds me of. You know, what is that, people will ask? Is that some kind of photographic anomaly? Is that a spirit? I guess the best thing I can say is I don't really know. I just think it's kind of odd. I mean, it's not something that will show up on your digital photographs. Not very prevalent. So, Moss Beach Distillery was a place I investigated. Not really conducive to investigating.
Louis, I have a question about the photograph.
Sure.
Was anybody getting an impression at the time, like a psychic impression at the time?
Well, Peter James was with us that evening, and we showed him the photographs, and he didn't want to go out on the limb and say it was anything that happened, because there's no history of a fire ever hitting that building at all. But there is a interesting side note to the story that go back. Underneath this whole auditorium, there's a kind of like catacombish stuff down there that the manager of this building would not allow us to investigate. And we were desperately trying to get down there. And we know it exists because people have talked about it. And in fact, one of the caretakers there talks about it as well. And we just felt at the time, and we still feel, that the guy that was running the place was kind of holding back a lot of information about things that might have gone on there. But very heavy presence behind the stage and some other rooms up there as well. So,
thank you.
You're very welcome. Moss Beach Distillery was a place that I investigated on the way back from Brookdale Lodge up north. On the way back, this Brookdale Lodge is rumored to be haunted by the spirit or entity of a little girl that are believed drowned in the brook. This restaurant burnt down to its foundation, and then it was rebuilt using the old blueprints. I don't know, having said that, if any of the energy or residual energy from that building would then be left. I would have to say no, because I think wood is a pretty good retainer of energy, just my opinion. And I took many photos here. I